I want to preface this review by saying that I never liked the original Annie. Even as a kid, I could see what a bad movie that was. So imagine my surprise when I started seeing trailers for a remake, and it actually looked like it might be good. Well, now that I've seen it, I can say that while it's not a great movie, it is a rare example of a remake that drastically improves on the original. The film centers on Annie Bennett, a young girl whose parents left her behind because they couldn't take care of her. When they dropped her off, they left a note promising to come back for her someday, and she spends her nights waiting outside the restaurant where they left her in the hopes that they might finally be reunited. In the meantime, she lives in an apartment with several other girls overseen by the bitter alcoholic Miss Hannigan, who only took them in for the money she'd get from the state as a foster parent. After a chance encounter with billionaire cell phone magnate Will Stacks, she goes to live with him because he's running for mayor and thinks taking in an orphan will help his campaign. Unbeknownst to him, his campaign manager has other ideas. I don't want to spoil too much of the plot, so I'll leave it there. Some people have complained about this film turning a mostly white set of characters into a mostly black set, but I honestly didn't have a problem with that. The entire cast turns in decent performances, but the real standout is Quvenzhané Wallace as Annie. Relying on her to sell this movie is a smart choice, because she has a natural charm and energy that many young actors lack, and her chemistry with Jamie Foxx makes the whole thing work in a way you wouldn't have expected from a film like this. Cameron Diaz's cartoonish and hammy take on Miss Hannigan is also fun to watch, and you can tell she had a lot of fun doing it. The musical numbers were produced by Jay-Z, and it shows. But that's not a bad thing. While there are a couple of songs that don't really work, most of them do. Very well, in fact, and this is one of the most listenable soundtracks I've heard in a while. I confess, I had Tomorrow and Hard Knock Life on a constant loop for a couple of days after seeing it, and if either of those replaces Let It Go as the song people go nuts for, I would be totally fine with that. Now we come to the negatives. Other reviewers have commented on the film's length and how it could have stood to be a little bit shorter, and I have to agree. After starting strong and hooking you in at the beginning, the middle section does seem to drag on longer than it should, and if I were the one having to make cuts, I would say that the songs Opportunity and Easy Street could have been left out without really affecting the plot that much, especially since those are the two weakest songs in the film. Fortunately, that's not enough to drag it down entirely, and the film's climax is genuinely clever, using the modern-day setting to its advantage in some surprisingly inventive ways. It's true that that might date the film in the future, but for now, it works. As a whole, I would say that Annie is a good family film that you can feel safe letting your kids see. It never strays outside the boundaries of its PG rating, and in this day and age where Hollywood feels the need to insert needless adult humor into their movies whether it fits or not, that's a rare thing. I give Annie 3.5 stars out of 5. It doesn't reach the heights of great musical films like Chicago or Hairspray, but it's better than it has any right to be. Until next time, film nerds.